Hey everybody, Marcos Villegas here, being joined with Tom Loeffler, the Managing Director of K2 Promotions. We're here in Los Angeles, where it's kind of a surprise to see Orlando Salido and Mickey Roman, and I'm like, wait a second, Tom's promoting the show. So it's happening December 9th at the Mandalay Bay. So how did you get in the mix of this? Like, how is K2 involved in this?
Well, we have a good relationship with Zanfer Promotions. We're actually going to be the licensed promoter up there in Las Vegas. But you know, we did the Superfly show where we had so many different promoters involved, and it's going to be a similar thing where Zanfer is involved, Golden Boy is involved. There's going to be an HBO triple header. Eric announced that Francisco Vargas is going to be on one of the HBO fights. We're going to have Denis Shafikov on one of the HBO Latino fights. So it's going to be one of these collaboration of exciting fighters, a lot of different promoters involved in the show, and we're just excited to bring a fight like this, an HBO triple header, to Mandalay Bay. I mean, they had a rough stretch with the shooting incident that I had up there, but you know, Triple G is going to come. We're going to do a meet and greet for him and for the first responders on Friday night. He's going to invite them to the fight on Saturday. So this is really one of those shows that we feel like we can give back to the community. We priced it very well. It starts at $50 and it goes to $250. If you can get at the Mandalay Bay, one of the largest casinos in Vegas, a floor seat for $250 for an HBO show like this, it's going to, that's really kind of an early Christmas present for the fans, and really an appreciation for the fan support that they have given us throughout this banner year in 2017.
I like the Mandalay Bay, the arena, because it's a very, it's like, it's not too large, but it's not too small. So it's a good size arena. But now you threw like a wrench in my plans, because you told me Gennady's going to come and they got the Lomachenko fight happening in New York. What do you make of that? You guys are going head to head with that fight, and that fight is very anticipated by a lot of fans. So why have the decision to go on that date as opposed to maybe the next week or some other time?
You know, I don't make the HBO calendar. I just when they give a date, then, you know, we have to follow their programming. A lot of times networks will try to counter program against each other, or promoters. You know, I'm not that way at all. You know, I have a lot of respect for Top Rank and what they're doing with ESPN. You know, that they have a great show, sold out the theater in New York against two top fighters with Lomachenko and Rigondeaux. But, you know, my understanding with the HBO calendar is they got Cotto on December 2nd and they got Lemieux and Saunders on December 16th. So this was the only date that they had, and it happened to, you know, Mandalay Bay is not always open. Like you said, they have a great arena. They have great concerts in there, a lot of entertainment. So to have an open event in December at Mandalay Bay was a golden opportunity, and we jumped on that as soon as HBO had the announced the date. You know, again, a triple header like this, I think it'll be a great collaboration. This is going to be against two Mexican fighters who are nonstop, all action, and this is going to be the true Mexican style fighting. And Gennady's going to be there, like I said, on Friday night. So I think it'll be another great weekend in Las Vegas, and a lot of entertainment for the fans.
You mentioned collaboration, and you've been doing it a lot with the Superfly shows. Yeah. It's a good success, great success. There's a lot of people for that event. When's part two? I know Rogman Sai and Estrada is supposed to be the main event, but can you give us any more news on a date and who else is going to fill out that card when it happens in February?
You know, I look at just putting on the best shows for the fans. You know, I put my ego at the door. I just do whatever promoter that I can work with, or whatever fighter we can put on a show, as long as it makes the best fights, that's what I'm willing to do. And the Superfly was a perfect example of that. You know, we had six different promoters involved in that show, and that was probably one of the most successful events, especially in a lighter division, but, you know, that I've been involved in from top to bottom. It was just nonstop action. The fans came early at the StubHub Center, and when you had, you know, the debut of Inoue, as excitement, as much excitement as he brought, the Estrada win over Cuadras, and then Rungvisai having that just devastating knockout over Chocotito, is just, it was a tremendous night. You know, Superfly 2, we're looking at hopefully doing something in February, you know.
What date specifically, like what weekend?
We don't have a specific date or a specific venue for it, but we know that the winners are going to fight each other. Estrada's going to fight Rungvisai. If we can get Inoue back on the show, that would be great. Chocotito, the door is always open to him. He really opened the door for the lighter divisions. You know, someone being at 112, 115 pounds and being at the top of the pound-for-pound list, that's a big statement for his career and what he's accomplished. So he's one of the most exciting fighters that the sport has seen, and had some tough fights back-to-back-to-back. So he always provides excitement for the fans. And if there's a way to put Chocotito on the show, we'd love to do that. The two Arroyo brothers have expressed interest from Puerto Rico, McJoe and McWilliam. There's some exciting fighters out of the Philippines, Ancajas, Casimero, Sultan. You know, there's Eddie Hearn's guy, Yafai. You know, he's the WBA champion at 115. So there's really a lot of exciting fighters in that division. And the great thing is, unlike many other divisions, the lighter guys are willing to fight each other. They're willing to fight each other. They're not afraid of having a loss on their record as long as they get the opportunity to fight on HBO and they get the opportunity to put on an exciting fight. They really, jump at that opportunity.
Yeah, they want to get paid too, and they want to get seen by a lot of people. You mentioned Chocolatito. Has the team given you any indication that he is, in fact, going to return this year, and he will do so for February, or is he going to sit out a little bit more time?
It's not decided 100% yet. I have had discussions with his promoter, with Mr. Honda, and taken promotions, and now the feeling that I get is that Ramon definitely wants to fight again. He doesn't want to have that as his last fight. He wants to show that he's still at world-class level, world champion level. So, we'll see what they decide to do, along with his manager, Carlos Blandon, and then we'll go from there. But, Chocotito adds excitement whenever he's on the show.
You mentioned how you're working with all promoters at this point with these shows. Yeah. There's been indication from actually Dana White that he wants to go ahead and enter into boxing. What do you make of that, and how do you see the UFC coming in and doing the whole boxing thing? How do you see that playing out if it does in fact happen? Because he stated in multiple interviews that he is very interested in promoting boxing shows now.
Well, Dana has come up with a tremendous structure at the UFC. I mean, the success that company has had is, I wouldn't say it's unprecedented, but he's really left his stamp on the, combat sports. So if he can do what he did with the UFC and with MMA and transition that into the sport of boxing, I think he has a good chance of being successful. It just boxing definitely is a completely different sport than mixed martial arts. UFC did a pretty good job of creating kind of a monopoly where, they could create their own ratings, they can create their own mandatories, their own titles, and so they could force, unlike in boxing, they could actually force their fighters or dictate to their fighters who was going to fight each other, and that's why you see a lot of exciting fights in the UFC. In boxing, there's many different sanctioning bodies, a lot of different promoters that won't work with each other, TV networks that won't work with each other, so now it's a lot more fractured. And as a lot of people have experienced, a lot of people like to go into the sport of boxing, but then they get frustrated because there is a lot of politics, and it's hard to put on the best shows unless you're working with a lot of other promoters. So, we'll have to see what direction he goes into. I think maybe they got bit by the boxing bug with the McGregor and Mayweather fight. They saw, how big a successful boxing pay-per-view can be, both on the ticketing and the international side and on the pay-per-view side. So, like I said, Dana's had a lot of success in mixed martial arts, and we'll see what he wants to do if he does make the also go into boxing.
I know the press conferences will be a lot more interesting. Knowing him, he's going to be telling people, that's a stupid question, and you're going to be hearing that left and right if that does happen.
Dana brings his own brand of entertainment to the media event. So, yeah, sure, there would be, he would bring his own excitement to the boxing.
I know everybody watching this is like probably thinking at this point. Oh, go ahead.
Plus, Dana's a big Triple G fan. In fact, I've seen where he said that he only watches boxing when Triple G fights. So we got to respect him for that. He's really been supportive of Triple G and the fights that Gennady's had. And I think he recognizes that Gennady is one of those rare guys that's willing to fight anyone and wants to put on exciting fights. And that's why we've had the success that we've had with Gennady. And I think Dana for sure recognizes that and respects what Gennady's accomplished inside the ring and what we've accomplished with him outside the ring.
Did you see him that night? Because I know he was there.
I saw him at the when we actually sat next to him when Canelo fought Chavez. We were sitting with Gennady and Abel, and he was sitting just one row behind us. So we saw him that night. I didn't see him at the at our fight because there were so many things going on. You know, when Triple G fought Canelo, but we saw him at the Chavez fight.
Because I was curious to see how he scored it. If you had a chance to talk to him about it, see how he scored the fight.
I don't know how he scored it, but I'd be willing to bet that Dana had Triple G winning that fight, like 80%, 90% of the rest of the people.
How's Gennady doing since everything that's happened? How is his feelings, and what does he convey to you about what happened that night?
You know, Gennady's doing fine. He had the baby girl the week before, the Friday before his fight, so that would mentally throw off a lot of people, you know, having a huge life-changing event like that. But he's doing fine. You know, he was he thought he won the fight. We all thought he won it like Harold Edelman scored it 8-4. So, you know, had the judges scored it the same like HBO did, who's, you know, both guys are with HBO, Harold's a neutral judge, this would be a completely different conversation. But, you know, unfortunately, two of the judges saw it differently. We wound up with a draw, but Gennady still has all his titles. He's still the champion. He feels like the champion. He feels like if Canelo wants to be a champion, he's got to, you know, fight him again. And, you know, that's really the priority. Gennady has expressed that, you know, his priority is to make the fight that the fans are asking for. They want to see the rematch. It was financially a very successful event, and that was one of the few mega fights that actually delivered in the ring. We had the great fight between Vladimir Klitschko and Anthony Joshua. That one delivered in front of Wembley Stadium, 90,000 people, and this is one of those fights in Las Vegas that delivered, you know, in the ring between you know, Gennady pressing the action and Canelo, you know, fighting, you know, when. You know, kind of throwing some of the more flashy punches. But I think the only way to resolve that is to do the rematch. And then, you know, both guys will have to make a bigger statement to convince the judges.
So what's going on with the rematch? Give us an update. At this point, where are the talks? And then are you guys still targeting May?
Eric Gomez was here. I don't know if he's still here. He was at the media launch representing Mickey Roman. But I've been in regular contact with Eric, and you know, hopefully we can work it out. I don't think it should be that difficult to do it because the first fight was successful. You know, if you have two fighters that don't make a lot of money and they're like, oh, I don't want to fight that guy again, or they're pissed off at each other, you know, it was a great co-promotion. Both Canelo and Triple G respect each other, and they both went out of their way to actually promote the fight, and we showed their fan bases are perfect. They both have huge fan bases that complement each other. Gennady sold out, I think, now 8 venues in a row all over the world that he's fought out, his last 8 venues, and Canelo, with his fan base, sells a ton of tickets. We had the third highest gate in boxing history. Whenever you can do an event like that and break a million pay-per-view buys and, you know, just be successful, I think it was a tremendous event. And I think, again, you know, just going back to the same thing, if we can do it on Cinco de Mayo weekend, it would be something that the fans want to see.
The Lemieux-Saunders fight, a lot of people are seeing that as, well, there's that in play in case something doesn't happen right with the rematch. You guys worried about that at all, or are you fairly confident that it is going to happen in May?
No, I'm confident on the Triple G side. I can't speak for Canelo or Golden Boy, although Eric has, you know, said that's also their priority. I mean, look, both guys know that the rematch is like way up here financially for both guys, and anything else is much lower. You know, I mean, you saw when Canelo fought Liam Smith, they sold a lot of tickets in Dallas Stadium, but their pay-per-views weren't that great. And the same thing, you know, the Danny Jacobs fight was a great fight. You know, sold out Madison Square Garden for Triple G, but again, you know, their pay-per-views weren't anywhere near what we did with Canelo and Triple G. So both guys actually need each other for their career to make those mega fights. They actually sold more, the Triple G Canelo fight sold more tickets or produced higher ticket revenue than when Floyd fought Canelo. So I think everyone sees the value that both guys bring to the table, and Like I said, both guys, it seems to need each other to make this type of a mega event that really only happens once a year or once every couple of years when we see a fight like this in Vegas.
You got a lot of fans bothering Floyd, saying that he's scared to fight Gennady Golovkin. There's been a lot of clips, too. What do you make of all that?
Look, it's hard.
You think you guys can entice him to come out to fight Gennady?
It's hard to call out a fighter that's retired. You know, the only thing that, you know, if Abel gets asked a question or if I get asked a question, would Triple G fight Floyd? Of course, the answer is yes. You know, Gennady has a lot of respect for what Floyd's accomplished. He said out of that respect, Floyd would be the only guy that he would go down to 154 pounds to fight. But look, if Floyd's retired, then he's retired and he should enjoy his retirement. You know, he's earned a tremendous amount of money in the ring and has an undefeated career and has his faculties in place. And, you know, so you gotta give Floyd a lot of credit for that. If he does want to come back, then certainly the door would be open to fight Triple G. But there's no, you know, we could jump up and down all we want. But, you know, unless there's two sides that want to actually make the fight, then, you know, it doesn't make sense. If Floyd's retired, then he should enjoy his retirement. The only thing is like when Floyd gets interviewed and said, would you beat Triple G? And he always says, oh, that'd be an easy fight and Triple G has no special effects. And, you know, there's only one way to prove that, and that's actually fight, which a lot of people think that he would never get in the ring with Triple G. So I think that's where, you know, from both sides where the interest comes to see the fight. But, you know, unless there's actually, look, I have a good relationship with Floyd and with Leonard Ellerbe and with Al Haymon, so if there was any interest in that fight at all, I would know about it, and that would be an easy fight to put together.
So no interest at this point from their side?
None that's been expressed, no.
Okay. All right. Tom, as always, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Great chatting with
you, Marcos.
Here with Tom Loeffler in Los Angeles. I'm Marcos Villegas for Fight Up TV. Thank you guys watching us at home.